wife. There's so much pressure to deliver, but I deliver.
Million views on my basement. Two told me, bro, let's go out on vacation. I'm still on probation, big bro, I can't make it.
Queso has come back with another reaction. And today we're reacting to Wretch 32 and Avleon FITB. That's fire in the booth. Now, y'all been asking me to react to this since like the first UK reaction I done did, and I just sort of been waiting on it, you know what I'm saying? I had it on my list, but I said a couple videos ago, yo, man, the people not above but equal, and I really mean that, and all requests for reactions on the Patreon, I'm gonna do it, and I've gotten 3 Patreon requests for this so far, so, man, people not above, you heard all that, but before I get to this, boom, my Patreon has officially launched. Yo, that's the place where you can find all my exclusive content. Where you can make reaction requests or the comments of these videos. So where you can see my podcast, my classic album review, my classic music reviews, block content, all kind of content that's just too hot for YouTube. So if you want to support the Dipper, you want to go make a request, go join the Patreon. It's in that first pinned comment. Now I'm done talking. But before I
break it down,
hit that thumbs up button if you're new to the channel. Hey, how are you doing? Hit that subscribe button, because if you don't subscribe, your granny is a dirty, stinking little we popping off. The video contains, hold on. Very strong language and adult themes throughout. If you're easily offended, please choose another extra video. Y'all, I'm here for that. I like that. They saying, man, this ain't for the soft hearted. It's gonna get real gangsta out here. So if you can't handle that, go on and click on another one. All right. Little disclaimer. I'm here for this one. Yes.
I know you gonna dig this.
Yo, I seen the reaction to Fredo on this joint right there, and that was a classic right there. Cause this gotta be BBC, you know what I'm saying? British Broadcasting Company, Big Black Cock. This gotta be like the UK like sway flex type shit.
Yeah.
But you see Americans on these shits too.
Scammers!
Oh, they turned up. Is this what the fat white dude?
Made a lot of noise being silent. They labeled me remote, now I'm being scouted by Island. Beg you wanna.
Yeah. Oh. He ain't the first two bars like that. He ain't just snapping the first two bars. I made a lot. That's such a bar. I made a lot of noise being silent. He said, like, I ain't talk too much. My talent, my music, that's been making a wave. And getting scouted by I like that double right there. It's just so effortless. Hold on, you too smooth. Put my shades on. He on some cool shit, man. Cool shit, man.
And the beast, yeah.
Come on.
Scammers!
Get it!
Made a lot of noise being silent. Uh-huh. They labeled me remote, now I'm being scouted by Island. Beg you on a brother, I'm universal. It's timing, I've got way too much to decipher for any cipher. I'm trying to be so much.
Give it to- oh my God. For those non hip hop heads, this man just said 4 record labels, but all of them had a double, whether it be Island, Universal, all those, they all had a double entendre. I'm really, this is off rip, and I don't usually to a new artist start vibing to you this hard off rip. You know, if I end up liking a person, I probably enjoy the music, but seldom do I hear your first 4 bars and be like, where have you been all my life, nigga? Like, pause, but like, I love his cadence. I love his energy. I love his swagger. I love how he's so chill. Reminds you of like Nas, like just a calm ass, cool nigga.
Universal is timing. I've got way too much to decipher for any cipher. I'm trying to be so much greater than good for the greater good. I feel like Nas. All I need is one mic. Made you look. Neighbors that ain't never left my neighborhood. Had to burn bridges to make profit like Moses. There ain't a bush.
Yo. These niggas in the UK really be getting busy. when we speak of artists, like, holistically, they just have it. I'm starting to think, and you know, it'll be we're all reflections of our reality. We only know what we know. We don't know what we don't know, right? Well, beer growing in a weird place. But I might just be late, but I really think it's the UK's time. Y'all niggas are such great artists, or such good rappers. You guys got the backstories. You guys got the energy. You guys have your own world, whether it be like the grime or the actual UK rap, like, but there's their own subgenres. I'm starting to think it's the UK time, and it's time for us in America to stop sleeping on these niggas. What did this?
Never left my neighborhood, had to burn bridges to make profit like Moses, there ain't a bush. Ooh. Independence with a major push is ideal. I'm from T and that's real, I'm done trying to define trill. I should get all of my exes watches cause time heals. I'm with a new thing in the yard on some Netflix and why chill? Why
oh am I- my god. What you talking at? Cause you know, I like when a nigga talking shit, but when he talking shit and flexes at the same time, what y'all... He might get all his exes Rolexes because time heals. And it's just, there's that double there of the Rolexes. There's the exes and Rolexes that he's working off of when we speak to rhyme schemes. That rhyme scheme of X, Rolex right next to each other is so crazy. Like, I love when you watch, there's certain rappers that are really good. And when you get relaxed rappers that are really good, it reminds you of watching like a Jordan or like a Tim Duncan or like a Kobe or like a Dirk. These are all players that will do amazing things, but it's not going to look like Allen Iverson. It's going to be much calmer. It's going to look like he's not struggling to do it. Now, I love that rapper where it's, you can hear the pain in their voice and shit, but this gives you another dynamic on that spectrum of flows. And this is a flow that we don't get too much. Like the newest artist that I would say has this kind of flow might be like a Dave East, but Dave East doesn't have that, like, right when I heard this nigga, I go, that's a star. There's just certain people where it's like, that's a star. Why do I not know about him? Why am I not tapped in with him? And that's how I'm feeling. This is Rex 32. This is Rex 32. Let me know in the comments. But off rip, this nigga is a star.
Watches cause time heals. I'm with a new thing in the yard. I'm on Netflix and why chill? Why beat around the bush, but you ain't shaved, baby? Put you on invasion alert. I think I'm JK. The plan was to change the game and never let the game change me. So it's no strings attached until wireless main stage me. Yeah, like free.
Oh, shit. The goal was to maintain and change the game and never let the game change me. So there's no what, like, you can't pull my strings. He has such purpose. Like, when you hear him, it's like you can hear it in him. Like, no, I'm here for hip hop. I'm here for rap. I'm here to put me and my people in better situations. And I am ever being that. That's where the world I come from. I'm forever going to love that. I'm forever going to champion that. I'm forever going to support that. I know in this world, not all of us get second chances and shit. And so when you see a nigga rapping, coming from those worlds, coming from those communities and those environments, you should big him up a little bit. You should go, damn, this nigga might be the reason why somebody's grandma sleeps good tonight. You hear me? This nigga might be the reason why somebody's kids get some new shoes when he goes to school. I can hear the conviction. I can hear the commitment. I can hear the sense of responsibility, because like when I spoke to like a Fredo gave me that like young nigga energy, but a wise young nigga, but still a young nigga energy. Dave gives me more of that OG energy. Bro meets you somewhere in the middle where it's like, that's a big homie, but he not necessarily like an old head yet. I just think it's so amazing that there's so many in the UK, there's so many artists that I can genuinely relate to or I can make a connection with. And I can go, yo, I know a nigga like this. Yo, I seen a nigga like this in the UK. But that tells you, bro, there's real niggas everywhere.
Put you on invasion alert, I think I'm JK. The plan was to change the game and never let the game change me. So it's no strings attached until wireless main stage me. Yeah, like Flea said, can't you hear the difference? I'm in Cavalli and Shrews, but that's just religion. Every time I made you pay attention, I was worth the listen. My team consists of content, that's what you call consistent.
Yeah. Ow! My team is filled with content. That's how it's what you call staying consistent. Every nigga on my team is star. Every nigga with me is a star. That's how we did it. We all. That's real nigga shit. Because as content creators or whatever, and that was such a bar that just sort of like, cause I felt that when I was, hold on, let me move my chest a little bit. Hold on the God. As content creators, you know, our first plan B. If I can get my homie from the hood, he sell Reggie. If I can get him to hold the camera, if I can get my homie, he be doing home invasions to make the beats. If I can get my homie who robs niggas, he could be my manager. You want to take everybody around you and put them in situations the whole time? Nah, there's niggas who are best suited for that. We would all love to put our homies in them situations. But nah, I need a team of stars. I'm trying to make the Monstars. I'm not trying to make the Charlotte Hornets. You know what I'm saying?
Attention, I was worth the listen. My team consists of content, that's what you call consistent. Yeah, ignorance has never been as bliss as now. I wondered why I never got a look in when I listened out. The maddest thing is being yourself is what makes you different now. But pay me no mind and I won't need it because I think aloud. Sometimes 1,000 words are worth a picture. Ignore the fact that I'm an artist, that's why I'm on Insta. Hard work breeds success, and although I'm in labor with Harmon.
This nigga might just be perfect. On the hood, this nigga, he just might be perfect. Cause he said, I love when you're giving me bars. I love when you're giving me bars and you're not just saying words. He's telling a continual story, and it takes a certain type of artist to understand it. He is speaking to the feeling of, he's struggling with self-worth. Because self-worth can be tricky. You know you that nigga. I know I'm that nigga. But how do I convince you I am that nigga? So he's saying, like, I'm looking around and my team's put together well. The talent's there. I'm that nigga. I know I am. But they slept on me. But in this very moment, I'm starting to go get, I'm getting attention from the labels and all of this shit. And this is just speaking to how he feels about this. This is storytelling. With certain genres of rap, you have to understand that the stories that are being told from a specific type of narrative. It's not going to be the Slick Rick or the Dave like my ex, those kind of storytelling. That's storytelling right there on the nose. You grab that. But this is a different form of storytelling. Me just telling you about my day. Just me or telling you about how I feel about a given situation. That is a different form of storytelling. And he might not get that credit he deserves.
No, that's why I'm on Insta. Hard work breeds success. And although I'm in labor with her, I'm gonna need a midwife. There's so much pressure to deliver. But I'll deliver.
Need a midwife because there's so much pressure to deliver. America, it's like 9 o'clock in the morning, 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm recording this shit. We need to get together, America. We need to have a little meeting. I'll bring Jamal. Jamal, come on. We all come into this meeting because. These UK niggas is kicking our necks in, let's be honest, bro. It's getting to the point where it's like, every time I hear a different artist from the UK, I'd be like, yo, why is this nigga not on my, in my constant rotation? I don't listen to any music, like I don't listen to artists that I react to without reacting to them. Does that make any sense? So I won't go watch Omegle bars, the newer ones, without being recording, because I don't want to like miss that first time experience with the records, right? So when I hear this nigga, Wretch, I'm just calling him Wretch. If he's Avalon, on my bad. But if I'm thinking he's Wretch. When I hear this nigga, I go, why is Gunna's album on Rap Caviar? Why is his shit not there? One of the craziest things about going through this, like, UK rap is it damn near makes you start thinking a lot about the gatekeepers and the people who stop Queso from ever hearing this. And that's the importance of platforms like mine. That's the goal. We're trying to create a new wave where it's like, I don't give a fuck if you live in Hong Kong. If your music is hitting and you got something to say, I'm here for this. Because honestly, tell me, and I want someone who's not a fan of this man, one of the people who just came from my channel, tell me, what is he missing right now? Why is he not a superstar?
And I had mine, went from trap lines to captivating you with lyrics. That's a trap line. Where I'm from, there ain't no helping hand. There's just gang signs. Holy yeah. Water flows when you hear back, that's short for baptized. Naming lights not in a list. Name a pair of rappers that could walk in our Rizzle kicks. 2016 is the rise of the lyricists.
Yeah. Oh, is that Avelino? Was that Avelino?
You just gotta listen to it, though.
You just gotta listen to it. Pay attention to it.
Yeah.
Wow. Bet you ready after that, yeah?
I'm good, man.
You sure? you gonna sit down for a minute? Is it a breather?
That was Avalon. Just a rap.
Yeah. Wow.
Lately, death's been getting ever so close. Feeling spirits while I'm driving, I should get me a ghost. Growing up, didn't know the difference.
That's a motherfucking bar on my hood. That's a bar.
Death's been getting ever so close. Feeling spirits while I'm driving, I should get me a ghost. Growing up, didn't know the difference.
That was a triple entendre. Feeling spirits, as in like feeling like a spirit, like a spiritual being. Feeling the spirits, like drinking. Feeling the spirits, the actual triple, what makes it a triple is because ghosts, like a cult, like. Your first two bars can't be a setup to a triple, bro. You can't just be rapping like this, nigga. I'm mad. I'm pissed off. Jamal, is you mad? That's how I feel too. I'm a
hug. I'm nice.
Wow.
Lately, death's been getting ever so close. Feeling spirits while I'm driving, I should get me a ghost. Growing up, didn't know the difference between the road and my home. Now I'm grown, I'm trying to buy every home on my road. Takeaways been on.
He ain't know the difference between road and his home. He ain't know the difference between the streets. And now he's trying to buy every home on the. He's trying to buy his block back. That's real talk. That's real empowerment. That's real. That's money talk. That's flexing. Buying back our communities, returning our, you know what I'm saying, returning the stores. We don't need Whole Foods in the hood. Motherfuckers can't afford that. Nigga, grandma been in the hood for 55 years. We don't need no Whole Foods. Let the little spot that be selling cigarettes out the back, let them stay here. We can afford that. You know what I'm saying? When you are a true lyricist, when you have true things to speak of, you don't gotta be in this bitch articulating it like Einstein. What I just described to you was gentrification at its simplest. We can't. He just described to you gentrification in his first couple bars.
This nigga white Hong Kong. The UK nigga.
So now I'm going to the UK. I'm on papers, I'm going to the UK.
I know the difference between the road and my home. Now I'm grown, I'm trying to buy every home on my road. Takeaways been overreached, I need a chef to come and live with me. Last time I picked up a pot, I nearly killed a fiend. I don't see a potent rapper out there that can mirror me. When I gave my kidneys to these kids, they must be kidding me, yeah. Remember playing Operation, yeah. That's how I feel about these compilations. Think they're the next Dr. Dre until they lose their patience. Saying the game's in a statement, that's an understatement. I mean, how much more gems can I drop on the future? How much of my fans might just not buy my new stuff? We've all got bars, but nobody hears a brew. I'm bringing sandwich to the beach.
shot in the hope of finding tuna. This is nonsense. Past tense. I'm a rap genius. Past sense. So if you ain't got a true one, then you ain't free to. You gotta graduate before you pass Rex. We got off on the wrong foot because you half step. Meanwhile, I'm getting restless because I can't rest. 21 hours I'm awake. The other 3 I'm in the days writing what to say with my last breath. Can you not hear the difference?
I need a drink. I need a beverage because of my life. The bars are so hot, my throat damn near dried up, cuz I ain't gonna lie to you. So that's Wretch. We're gonna call him Wretch. Everybody Wretch now. When he went in, I was like, yo, I don't know if he's gonna be able to. Bro, just. And then he did that. And now I'm in this motherfucker like, who am I? And who are you? Because me knowing who I am, something that fire just can't come out like that. That's just, it's not possible. Cuz had to shut him the fuck up.
Come on, man. Stop me, man.
Yo, I need you to rewind the track for me, brother. Rewind the track.
Hey, fam, what's up, say?
I needed to turn down my headphones as well.
Yo, I didn't know that's how these niggas was coming.
Goosebumps at it.
Go again.
They like, nigga, let me keep rapping.
Well, it's gonna take a moment.
Oh, man.
Just a moment.
That fire, old flame coming soon. All right, me out now. Yeah.
Lately death's been getting ever so close. Been feeling spirits while I'm driving, I should get me a ghost. Growing up, didn't know the difference between the road and my home. Now I'm grown, I'm trying to buy every home on my road. Takeaway's been over-rinsed, I need a chef to come and live with me. Last time I picked up a pot, I nearly killed a fiend. I don't see a potent rapper out there that can mirror me. When I gave my kidneys to these kids, you must be kidding me. Do you remember playing Operation? Yeah, that's how I feel about these compilations. Think they're the next Dr. Dre until they lose their patience. Saying the game's in a statement, that's an understatement. I mean, how much more gems can I drop on the future? How much of my fans might just not buy my new stuff? Oh. You got bars, but nobody hears a brew. I bring a sandwich to the beach in the hope of finding tuna. This is nonsense. Past tense. I'm a rap genius. I've past sense.
So wow.
If you got a 2-1, well, you ain't free to. You gotta graduate before you pass Rex. We got off on the wrong foot because you half step. Meanwhile, I'm getting restless because I can't rest. 21 hours I'm awake. The other 3 I'm in the days writing what to say.
They gotta change this from freestyle to record, bro, because this is a song. Like the dynamic between the two artists, I love how Avalon, I'm gonna call him Avalon, I love how he comes in like a more controlled, cool kind of style with passion, but the passion is more in his, like, in his thought is what's the most like, that man really has something. But then you have somebody like Wretch, who while he's saying something, the conviction in his voice alone makes you feel it. Makes you be like, wow, this is real. This is something that must be heard. And when you get two artists that different, that contrasting fundamentally, and you put them on a record together and they're able to coexist, that is how you get a banger, and this is a banger.
Hey, with my last breath, can you not hear the difference?
Perfect.
Even when it's in your system, every time I flip the script, I got a scripture. I've seen man go from the strip to the strip club. I'm trying to go from eating rich tea to the rich club. I used to want to go from the bitch to the bricks cards, and then I realized that it's a fix when your skin's dark. Should I do a Kanye and keep it chiller?
And this is real gems. He said This nigga might be the goat. This nigga might be the goat, bro. Hold on, these things that you're buying and shit, it's just a fix for us with this pigment. It's just we just need it. We're trying to buy our value back. We're trying to feel important. So we need the nice clothes and the shiny chains and shit like that, and the finest of bitches and the nicest of cars, because for so long systemically we were told we were nothing, and so now systemically we have an urge and a desire to prove that we have value. But like I said earlier, like when he spoke to gentrification, he didn't say it like that. And because I think in making content, it's very important to know who your listener is, because it's the reason why there's picture books and there's novels, right?
You have to know who you're delivering this content. Not saying that a person who reads a picture book can't read a novel. He probably can, but he just enjoys getting his, digesting his content in that forum. When you have people who are speaking for these communities and shit like that, I love it so much when you can hear these communities. When you can hear that they are a representation of where they come from. When you can really hear that and feel it. I love that. Because can't nobody tell you what's wrong with me better than me. This man is talking about buying our humanity back. And some artists slip it in, but with the gold grizzly.
And then I realized that it's a fix when your skin's dark. Should I do a Kanye and keep it chiller? Fuck that. Even when I lose, I'm the winner. I'm people's trap, let me fight the people.
Yeah.
Never got the point until they grab the needle. Niggas try to minus my pluses to divide my people. They go from stepping on roaches to stepping by the beagles. It's progression at its finest. They say my weakness is kindness. I kill them with success because it's timeless. Every verse is a verse from the chapter of writing. The writing's on the wall, we know who destiny's child is. King Kendrick or Jermaine Cole? Are you saying King Richard or Jermaine's code? I'm trying to lay the blueprint and give you reasonable doubt so when you watch the throne, they can see me change clothes.
Okay. Oh, my God. When you watch the throne, I'm trying to hear. He just said every JC. Bro, this nigga coming with some real bars. Real boss.
Print and give you reasonable doubt so when you watch the throne, they can see me change clothes. Wait, you best believe that.
And that's such a bar because you've seen that Jay-Z commercial where he's taking pictures of every one of his album covers, but he's switching. Oh my God. That's such a bar.
Reasonable doubt so when you watch the throne, they can see me change clothes. Wait, you best believe that I'm a general because one of us has got to compete at all the festivals and I've been out here rapping for free before my testicles drop, man. I'm so credible, I'm incredible. They say a promise is a comfort to a fool. I'm lying if I want to say.
And I love how he just will. I love that rhyme scheme he's doing where sometimes the middle rhymes hit too. Eligible, credible, but there's still end rhyme. When you're rhyming like that, when you're getting that kind of swagger off, when you're getting that kind, when you have that kind of bounce in the booth, that's just such a, like, you are meticulously making sure that there's no filler, no bar in there. Every single bar is hitting us like an earthquake.
And comfort, I'm the truth. And this will be the best fire in the booth. And I doubt they'll tell you different when I'm standing in the room. What? Different class. Sometimes you have to ask, do you want to be the best in your country or your school? In a country full of rules where we're sending lollipop to keep them sucking on our rules. The survival.
He's saying we staying distracted in this motherfucker, in this country. I ain't in y'all country, but I feel you. And he said, would you rather be the best rapper in your country or your school? He's starting to realize that this shit was bigger than just his block, than just his homies. He's starting to realize that he could impact the world from his voice. Watching someone, the experience, like I speak to how much I love music is being able to take a step into someone's brain, but watching that, watching a man really make that decision of, no, I can be great. I'm not going to just be a reaction channel with 10,000 subs. Time of this, we almost tripled that. We more than tripled that. Almost quadrupled that. It's when you find your purpose, when you find, okay, this is what I gotta do, this is who I am. And when it's meaningful, that's a moment. And I'm watching this through Wretch.
Different class. Sometimes you have to ask, do you wanna be the best in your country or your school? In a country full of rules where we're sending lollipop to keep them sucking on our rules. The survival of the fittest, so I'm more Farrah. I'm black as Akon, just trying to find my own Gaga. The less mercy you show could leave.
Bro, throw the talent. This nigga is cold.
So I'm more Farrah. I'm black as Akon, just trying to find my own
Gaga. Hold on.
Mercy you show could leave you merciless alone, but I'm yard grown, so I ain't taking no better.
And it's like I was speaking to, it's like merciless, mercy, all just using those middle rhymes or middle repetition to continue on your rhyme scheme. You can tell he is a true MC, he's a true lyricist. He really puts time, work, and effort into his bars because these are not just Dr. Seuss. These are bars, a little multi-layered, dimensional, different angles, cadence, writing, and this beat, it's the beat for me. It's some cool shit mine. But you don't see, would we consider him drill? I haven't heard any of this. I'm just going based on his content. Would you consider him drill? Because we don't see drill or hardcore gangster rappers hopping on beats like this. This give you that beat. I just suddenly rose touching A by day. You know a song, I can't think of it. Stop, don't stop believing. Like, it's one of those, like, 80s rock joints, but he just in there, bitch, giving it to you.
Mercy, you sure could leave you merciless alone, but I'm yard grown, so I ain't taking no better. No, and Tidal's got the...
And I love that. Niggas who come from the streets who... It's, bro, I'm from this. We come from the bottom of the bottom, so it's like, sometimes it's like, nigga, I don't... What you gonna tell me? You gonna kill me? You gonna send me in prison? No? Okay, then I'm not scared. I love that! Grab your nuts, cuz! Tell that nigga we from here. There's certain people, bro. I don't know where Buddy's from in the UK. I don't know his hood. But if you are from where this man is from, at this point, I'm not even 100% positive what his name is. If you are from where he's from, it's a must you support this nigga. It's mandatory because... This nigga putting on for your hood, man.
Whole world moving crazy. It's like they rob a free Spotify playlist. That's messed up, like them cops on the day shift.
Wait, what'd he say?
It's like they rob a free Spotify playlist. That's messed up, like them cops on the day shift. Who just can't stop and search about tasing. Shit seems shocking when you're reading about it. 6 years old, they was raiding my house, shit.
Yo.
Trying to find my uncle, didn't open my mouth, shit. My dad might have killed me, no snitching on our shit. The Titanic ain't going down because of me. See, I can't swim, but I'll be the anchor for the scene. See, how do they expect musicians to stay afloat when all ourselves keep going down the street? Fire in the booth, young fire, old flame, all right, me. I've got nothing to say.
Let me just say that.
I drew.
Let me tell you something right now.
You said it last time, don't say it again.
I'm up for safe. That right there. That right there.
Do we go back here?
Animals in the building. And that right there.
Bro, that was a certified vibe check. Keep coming with these UK artists because, bro, they just get it. And they have that heart and they have the spirit and they have the vibe of hip hop. And they have that weird ability that instantaneously they can connect with you. Instantaneously you can be like, yo, I'm supposed to be listening to this right here, and this man right here is I'm supposed to hear this song, and this man is the person supposed to be giving me this song. You instantly just fall in love with it. You instantly have so much trust in the artist. You instantly have so much intrigue for where they're going to take the record. These UK niggas is different. Now here comes a reaction by me right here. Bing. Or a music video by me right here. Bing. Or my Patreon. Boom, boom, boom. In this box. Click on it. Show me some love. KBD family, love y'all. Salute. I'm out.